go to Joe, calling from Fresno, California. Joe, welcome to Catholic Answers Live.
Thanks for having me. My question is for Father Vincent.
Mm-hmm.
Father Vincent, I've struggled with looking at pornography most of my entire life. I'm 54 years old. I started at a very young age, probably 10 or 11. And there was a while that I actually gave it up completely for many years. But I found myself recently glancing and actually seeking out pornography about once every 3 weeks, maybe once a month. And I go to confession. I confess, you know, my lust in my eyes and in my heart, and I receive absolution. But it almost seems like I'm mocking God because I go back to confession and I confess the same sin that I've already confessed before. And so my question to you is, am I receiving absolution each and every time, or did I receive that one time and that's all I need? And why has God not removed this yoke from me after I've asked him to do it for years and years and years?
Well, each time you're absolved, that sin is forgiven. But you do need to confess it again if you commit it again. The Lord will only do for you what we can't do for ourselves. And if he's not doing it for you, it means that there are still some ways that you can use to discipline yourself. And one of them, there's an organization in which it's a program in which you have a partner. And if you go online to a pornography site, he will be notified of it. And so it's not only you that know you're slipping. He does too, and he can remind you or tell you. And you do that for each other, and it works quite well. And I'm trying to desperately to remember the name of the program. I know that Matt Frad works with them, but I can't.
Is it Covenant Eyes?
There you
Father?
Go, Covenant Eyes. Yes, Covenant Eyes. If you Google Covenant Eyes, you get some information on how to make use of this program, because it makes you more responsible, and you realize, you know, you're going to think twice before doing it if you know somebody else is going to see you and know that you're falling. And of course, we'll respond. We'll let you know, knock it off. You know, don't do this. Let's talk about something else. Whatever. You know, it's a concrete help. And it seems to me, you know, you need that. And evidently, the Lord wants you to try to discipline yourself more than certainly prayer is good. But he wants more from you in this. And so there's an opportunity for you to work on it.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead. Does that sound feasible to you?
Yes, I appreciate your answer. I guess the second part to my question is that when I'm confessing my sin to the priest, invariably he would say, well, save five Hail Marys or four Our Fathers.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder the weight of that those prayers, because I say three rosaries and 10 Our Fathers. Mm-hmm. So I ask myself, why four Hail Marys? How do I reconcile that question?
The penance isn't meant to make up for your sin. The Lord has done that. It's an expression, it's a reminder that what you did was wrong, and you say these prayers to remind you that you're weak and that you have to be more careful in the future. That's what the penance is. The penance isn't to really pound it out of you. It doesn't work that way. The important thing is to, it's amazing the games we can play, you know, with ourselves, mental games. You know, when we know, you know, if you knew that the next time you did it, you'd receive an electric shock, you wouldn't do it, you know. But you don't. It doesn't happen, you know. So we have more freedom than we realize. And it's easy to think that, you know, if just Lord would only just come in and take away the temptation. These things are necessary for us because they make us recognize more fully how much we need the Lord. We don't want to need him. We want to be perfect and not have to need him, but we wouldn't love him much that way either. This brings the best out of us because we're trying to please him because we don't want to displease him. And we'll go to great lengths for that. That's what he's hoping will happen with you which is the reason why he's allow you to have this difficulty. This stumbling block seemingly can become a stepping stone if you work on it.
I just feel like I'm mocking God's grace.
No, you're weak. Acknowledge it. It's okay. It should not be a surprise. We're all weak, but it's glorious when we try hard enough, and with the Lord's grace, we cooperate with His grace, and we're able to stay away from it. And that's what it really is. You don't fight it headlong. You stay away from it. You don't go there in your head before you go to the to the computer. You know, you're already open to it when you turn that computer on at that particular point. Why do people do it? They're bored. They're frustrated. It's an escape. They just want some pleasure right away. All those things, you know, but they don't have to. It's not absolutely necessary for us to go in those directions. You'll see something and it'll trigger something, and then you're already decided to do it before you even put your hand on the keys.
True.
So this way, if you know there's a price to pay, there's another person who's going to be involved. It's going to be a little bit embarrassing, and you'll be less likely to do it.
Father, I appreciate it.
Okay, good enough.
Appreciate the call, Joe. Thank you, and thanks for those wise words. Let's.